few weeks ago, we had a customer call us with an issue. He had two tachometers for two Cummins marine engines on his boat, and he wanted to add two traditional-looking tachometers to the J1939 CAN bus. The two engines each have a unique source address. The default source address for the first engine is 0. A Cummins software engineer has advised that the second engine ECM be converted to 1 when installed in a twin engine configuration. When the customer connects the tachometer with engine source address 0, the tachometer works perfectly. However, when he wires the tachometer to engine source address 1, it does not work. Our tests revealed that the J1939 driven tachometers only recognize RPM from engines with source address 0. We can explain our idea with puzzle pieces. The J1939 driven tachometer accepts RPM directly from engine source address 0. Engine source address 1, however, will need a gateway as a bridge to drive the tachometer. Allow me to demonstrate how we solve this issue in our lab. Here, we have a J1939 simulator act as an engine with a default source address 0, and we have another J1939 simulator act as an engine with a configured source address 1. Here is our gateway with two independent and physically isolated CAN buses. The bus on the left provides input to the gateway. In turn, the gateway outputs all the way through another bus to a traditional bus-driven tachometer. We also have the power supply as well as two 120-ohm terminal resistors. First, I connect the source address 0 simulator to the CAN bus on the right. Since the gauge recognizes the source address, the pointer moves almost immediately. However, when we attach the simulator with engine source address 1 directly to the gauge, the pointer doesn't move. Using a J1939 data center, we can see the source address of the engine simulator is 001 on the data center GUI. Here is where our gateway comes in. As I mentioned before, the gateway can convert source address 1 to source address 0. Let's see what happens. As you can see, the engine speed from engine source address 1 is available because of the gateway. The gateway has converted the source address from 1 to 0. Let's use Au J1939 data center to verify this information again. We can see the source address of the simulator displayed as 0 instead of 1 on the GUI. If you run into similar issues or need technical support, you can contact us at support@auelectronics.com. Hopefully, this video was helpful for you. Thanks for watching!